Dear students, in this class we are going to discuss second lesson P block elements. So boric acid. Last class we have discussed borax. Then boric acid also we have discussed up to the preparation of boric acid. Preparation of boric acid. Now in this session we are going to discuss physical and chemical properties of boric acid. Physical and chemical properties of boric acid. See, hydrogen borate, boric acid is nothing but hydrogen borate and then monobasic Lewis acid. Do you know what is meant by Lewis acid? So Lewis acid, in the sense, it accepts an electron. Based on the electronic concept, Lewis acid is electron deficient. It can act as an electrophile. It accepts an electron. These are all the definitions about Lewis acid. அப்படி நம்ம சொல்றோம், right? So the based on the basic monobasic and it acts as a Lewis acid. So it accepts an hydroxyl ion from the water molecule. See the chemical, first chemical properties, boric acid with the water molecule. Boric acid is weak in nature, so that it maintains equilibrium with the reactant as well as product concentration. Okay, so boric acid accepts an hydroxyl ion, then it forms tetrahydroxyboron and then hydronium ion. It forms hydronium ion. Then reaction with sodium hydroxide. Boric acid is a weak base, weak acid. So weak acid which is reacts with a strong base, that is sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide with boric acid, it forms sodium metaborate plus water molecule. And then excess 2 moles of sodium hydroxide with boric acid, 4 moles of boric acid, it forms sodium tetraborate with expel 7 water molecule. And then the third chemical property, action of heat. Action of heat is nothing but if there is any water molecule, it will be removed easily. That's all. So here there are 3 steps were involved in the action of heat. When boric acid is heated at 373 Kelvin, then it forms a metaboric acid. Then it expel 4 water molecules from it. Okay, right? Then further, metaboric acid undergoes heat. Metaboric acid heated with 413 Kelvin, then it will become, what is that? Tetraboric acid. Tetraboric acid. What will happen? Slowly the water molecule will be removed. Finally, a complete water molecule removed from the compound, then it forms anhydride. Then third step, it will become, the temperature will be higher. That means the red hot condition. Sinjudana nilayila. So, okay, what will happen here? The tetraboric acid in the red hot condition. What will happen? The every water molecule, completely the water molecule will be removed from the compound. Then it forms boric anhydride. You know that boric anhydride. Anhydride, which means, what is that? There is no water molecule in the substance or a compound. அப்படின்னு சொல்றோம். அந்த சேர்மத்தில் என்ன இருக்காது? நீர் மூலக்கூறே இருக்காது. அதுதான் நம்ம வந்து anhydride அப்படின்னு நம்ம சொல்றோம். Then what will happen here? So the tetraboric acid, when heated up to red hot condition, then it forms a boric anhydride. Boric anhydride. So there are 3 steps that are involved in the action of heat, right? Then action of ammonia. Action of ammonia. Fusion of urea. So boric acid fused with urea, and then it treated with ammonia. So in the sense of the atmosphere of ammonia, boric acid fused with urea. Urea, you know the chemical formula of urea. Urea is a diamide, CONH2 twice. It has a bifunctional group, right? It is reacts with ammonia. Then it forms boron nitride. So fusion of urea with boric acid in an atmosphere of ammonia at 1200 Kelvin. So boric acid with ammonia by heating boron nitride, BN, boron nitride, boron with nitrogen. So nitrogen inga vandu pathinga negative, so that boron nitride, we are mentioning boron nitride with elimination of 3 water molecules. So we have throughout the session we have discussed up to few chemical properties. The remaining chemical properties of boric acid we were discussed in the next session, right? So throughout the session physical and chemical properties of what is that boric acid we are discussed, right? So next class we are going to discuss remaining chemical properties and structure of boric acid and then uses of boric acid. Okay, right. Thank you.